na kojo jali me la ani shechi evre bura na mo okola ebura na no kunye no ye nyamre odai imekeju idu osa eva ivre kojo.
The demise of Honorable Kojo Ama is a very big blow to me, and I know it's a big blow to a lot of people, especially members of the CPP fraternity. I knew of Honorable Ama as a child when we used to worship together at St. Thomas More Catholic Church at Chimota. One thing I can speak about him was his humility.
Generally, he had a disposition which was one of the best. He associated very well with everybody, young, old, anybody of any stature, he associated very well. He advised, he was always involved in matters, and he was one person who always resolved issues when conflict arose.
Honorable Kojo Ama, former MP for Evaluadra in the Western Region, was announced dead on the 4th of May 2014.
Honorable Yobia Nehojo, Owaho Brasie, or a big man, and so Owaho Brasie, or nice to everybody. My time soon in this year, I send you a bit of a crack at some jokes. And my one day, into a bar, say a tea, say a femono. A real hole. And my union, I dear real one, and so in the paddy, and yet they are young cancer, I see soon, and done a boy. There will be a beco near Kubi or Kunta.
Kakakra, Emma. Nyani likunye nukwa kiyidi nyamri yedileti yele seleke odai uchichi ye nyane na oma ye elole nukungu yele na oye ye muare oma ye yake ngenzili na mo okie ye mofata kie ba ye ne yava kujo yava ya adore kakware na odanku ye liye isali miu wo onwune hanala imo ye kakakra ye guajre mo yele ye mwre amuare ne shishele niya.
I've known Kojo Ama since 1990, when I was then working with the National Commission on Culture, and he was the Administrative Secretary of Ghana Museums and Monuments Board.
To make it in life calls for dedication, focus, hard work, and above all, being God-fearing, which he was. Eja Kojo, as he was affectionately called by his comrades and compatriots, was endowed with variety of qualities that positively impacted on many young chaps who in one way or the other had the opportunity to meet and engage with him.
When he was appointed as the district chief executive under the Kufuor's administration in Axim, I was a frequent visitor to his office. I could see how he was fully relating to the people on the ground and the party. It was no wonder that for several occasions he was elected as the representative of the people in parliament. He was somebody who was always very close to the people. He was always seeking the welfare of the people around him more than he himself and his family.
He was always full of smiles and hope for those who had the chance to meet him for the first time in their lives due to his charismatic and gentle lifestyle. He worked hard to set an enviable pace for himself and the people he served at large.
My first encounter with the late Honorable Kojo Ama was 2000, I believe, when his son Didi Ama was at the Academy of Screen Art at East Legon. We became friends then, and somehow or another, from friendship, we became like brothers and sisters. And where I really got to actually have a direct interaction with the Honorable was whilst I was working at Ankobra FM. He's somebody who is extremely understanding, supportive, down to earth, totally down to earth, and very honest about anything that he didn't like or he liked.
Yeju adare yeli juma wa mariano munkojo ayerijuma dede mane ya fi yesere woke ah sina mboni ya kurujuma yereze adawu biara wujoka hare ese mame nye juma onwa ka nyamre bware mke manye juma se nyamre fa ina fere kware ne mame a ene mezeke miwe mi juma ye angba wujuma wuyeye.
Honorable Kojo Ama, as part of his contribution to the socio-political environment of Ghana, was made the General Secretary of the People's National Convention from 1992 to 1994 under Dr. Hilal Liman, but resigned over disagreements on the issues of merger with other Nkrumahist parties. At the time of his resignation, he was the secretary to the technical committee of the unity talks that involved the PNC, NIP, PDPP, NCP, and other smaller groups.
I think we have lost a great person. For a time when he was handling the administration of the CPP in Accra, we all loved him. Because one person who was able to hold the party together for a moment.
Elili juma don warka. E derali sen don mamini. Oya baba ni elisunke ah. Na wede bebi a fa koko di juma mamini. Wanze ma brofo. Wili juma wane han don. Ngana kiara baba. Wili juma don vo mamini. En kan kan wo CPP. Ezo CPP karene. Enela ko enela ba. Mo bezuma wo mo okedo mu anefo ahun zujuma efeye enyeri omu akosoti.
James Evans Ama was born on 27th November 1945 to James Ejeno Enyima Ama and Sikayena Beidu of blessed memory in Axim in the Western region. As a child, he was brought up by his maternal aunt Mrs. Kwashi and her husband Mr. Kwashi. He attended Asokore Primary School from 1952 and later proceeded to Apam Roman Catholic Middle School. In 1960, he gained admission to Apam Secondary School, where he obtained his GCE Ordinary and Advanced Level Certificates. In 1966, he gained admission into the University of Ghana, Lagos, where he graduated with a BA Honours in political science in 1969. After graduation, he was employed by the Ministry of Education. He taught at Axim Secondary School, now in Science Senior High School, from 1969 to 1971. In 1971, he gained admission into the University of Cape Coast, where he graduated with a postgraduate diploma in education, where he was later transferred to Ghana Secondary Technical School, GSTS, Takrade, as a teacher from 1971 to 1973.
Honorable Kojo Ama, as I've known him, was a peacemaker. I have no dispute about that. I've known him to be very hardworking. He became the MP on two occasions in the Evarodura constituency and became the district chief executive also for one period.
In 1994, he joined the People's Convention Party, PCP, and was made Deputy General Secretary in charge of operations and served until 1996. He contested in the 1996 parliamentary elections on the ticket of the PCP and won a seat as the Member of Parliament for Evaluadra constituency from 1996. He contested in the parliamentary elections again in 2000 but lost his seat. Due to his dedication to serve mankind, he was recognized and appointed as the District Chief Executive for Nzema East District Assembly by President John Ajekum Kufo and served from 2001 to 2004. In 1973, he met and married Miss Sabaina Ama. Soon after, he was posted to the Research Bureau of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs as an assistant director too. He went on various diplomatic missions and held responsible positions. In 1973, He pursued a diploma in French language, literature and civilization from the University of Tours in Touraine, France. In 1976, he obtained a diploma in public administration at Ghana Institute of Management and Public Administration, GIMPA, and was promoted to the rank of Assistant Director 1 in 1977. After the coup of 31st December 1981, he was recalled home and served as the Deputy Head of Desk of the African and European Desk at the Research Department of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs from 1982 to 1984. He was seconded to the Ghana Museums and Monuments Board in 1984 as Administrative Secretary, where he worked for 3 years. He was then posted to the office of the Head of Civil Service as Deputy Director in charge of Personnel, Policy and Management. In 1987, he obtained his Bachelor of Law degree at the Ghana School of Law. He retired from the civil service in 1992 and went into private legal practice and politics.
He was a man that was humble and pure. I say pure in a sense that it was hard for you to find any wrong with him, even though at sometimes, as normal human nature, you would have a father being too strict and a father being too nice. But to sum it all up, he was the best dad for I and my sisters. I remember when we were growing up, we had our fun days in our house. It was a lovely home. We had our exciting Fridays that we all called the Jubilee Fridays, that usually my dad would come back from work and he would come in, would watch some TV, would have some good meals cooked by my mom, or my mom bringing in some good meals from the restaurant. My sisters and I playing ludus and also playing what kind of advert is coming up on the TV. Those were good memories, having it and sharing it with my father.
As a staunch Nkrumahist from the CPP tradition, he served on the Central Committee on the party from 1992 and was the Western Regional Representative on the committee at the time of his passing. He also served on many committees in various capacities, including Chairman, Dr. Kwame Nkrumah Centenary Committee, and organized a very successful family dialogue which crafted the roadmap for the party's reorganization. He served on the Congress Committee twice, as well as the Constitutional Drafting Committee, and was chairman of the Parliamentary Committee at the time of his passing. He was appointed chief liaison at the CPP headquarters to coordinate the administrative functions and activities of the secretariat in 2010. Honorable Kojo Amah served on many committees, including the Select Committee on Foreign Affairs, Committee on Appointments, Committee on Roads and Transport. He served as ranking member on the Subsidiary Legislation Committee and vice chairman of the Constitutional, Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee, as well as the Committee on Local Government and Rural Development. He was appointed chairman of the Ministerial Committee of Investigation into the Missing Cocaine at the Police Headquarters in 2008 and presented the committee's report to the president on completion. The report received acclaim in some quarters for his honesty, and he was praised accordingly for his bravery.
I will say that in my life, what I am today is Kojo Amah who made me what I am today. For all that I've achieved in life, I would say it's Kojo Amah. As I'm going to talk about the memories, there's a lot of memories. But one that really remembered is when I was around 9 to 10 years, we had a graduate when we were living in GSS in Takoradi. So I decided not to live with him again. I was going back to Axim to live with our parents. I carried my chop box to Axim. The next day, it was a Friday, I remember it was a Friday. The next day, that was Saturday, Kojo Amah was in Axim. And I remember him asking me, Kofi, Maba Hasu, Mobrowa, Ebefi Hasu, Akwana. So the Sunday, our mothers asked me how to carry my chop box again and followed him to Takoradi, that is when I realized that he's truly a brother to me, and this, he's part of me that I cannot go away from him. I remember that very well.
He was deeply involved in the development of the Evaluedra constituency and the Nzema East municipality, spreading many projects, including the establishment of the first FM radio station in Nzema, the Ankobra FM. The station gave the people of Nzemaland a platform to voice their concerns on various issues and also the opportunity to listen to the goings on the other parts of the country and beyond. He also encouraged the use of the radio station as a platform for the spread of the gospel of Jesus Christ by devoting a regular slot for religious programs at his own expense. He introduced an Italian NGO, COPS, which established such projects as Association of Small-Scale Industries, grouping basically artisanal operators, credit union and sanitation projects. COPS also established a mechanical training school at Beria and collaborated with an Italian university and cultural institute to establish the Nzema Museum and Cultural and History based at Fort Apollonia in Benin. He had a particular interest in environmental and green issues and made sanitation a priority during his administration as the chief executive of the Nzema East District. He attended two workshops in Pecoli, a municipality in Italy, to study their local government system with focus on that municipality's waste management practices, and indeed won two prizes for sanitation at the DCE's conference in 2002 and 2003. He worked closely with Coastal Resources Center, a USAID-funded organization that realizes in sustainable management of our coastal resources, including protection of marine life, coastal cleanliness, and currently dealing with the effects of oil and gas on the livelihoods of people living in the areas and particularly the ecosystem. In 2011, he also worked on a project through Ankobra FM with another USAID-funded organization, LogiDep, a local government-focused agency. At the time of his passing, he was working with a local environmental NGO, United Civil Societies of Nzema, and in collaboration with Ankobra FM on a program sponsored by Star Ghana to assess the quality of education and determine the causes of poor performance in schools from 16 communities of the four coastal districts of Ahanta West, Nzema East, Elemble, and Jomoro. He fell ill on Sunday, April 27, 2014, and was admitted at the Kolebu Teaching Hospital on Tuesday, April 29, 2014. After a few days at the hospital, he seemed to have recovered and was his usual hearty self, chatting with friends and family during visiting hours. He passed away suddenly on Sunday, 4th May, 2014 at the Kolebu Teaching Hospital. He is survived by his wife, Sabina, their three children, Akesimanzechi Sisi Ama, Sabina Sikayena Ablama Mimi Ama, and James Didi Ama, and five grandchildren, James Ejeno Ama, Kimani, Koshi Klole Labisian, and Jaden Danfo.
It's just very shocking and rather sad that he was called to glory. But I don't think anybody, especially me and the family, expected this to happen, but I'm glad and I'm actually honored that he was my father and I had the opportunity to know and to love him, and I will miss him dearly and all that he's taught me. So I just want to say rest in perfect peace, Dada.
We have all lost a great man. Ghana has lost a great man. The family have lost a great father. My message to them is to take heart. and they'll be consoled in the Lord.
It's hard and it's not easy dealing with the loss because it was shocking. But the last few encounters I had with him was a memorable one, which I know would be in our hearts forever.
People never leave you, though you don't see them again. You have some part of them still in your life each and every day.
Honorable, what the kind of day you nyamemfa won see ye be koso abompa ya mam se nyamem koso mfa won see na wachi enye fefefe unana nom na wo banyina entrance asumdwe mu na wodi mpa obejaye no wo mun so nkoso emadin ntre.
I want to say a farewell to Kojo for all the good works that he has done, for all the advice that he had done, all the lectures that he gave, and he'll be remembered till all of us depart this earth. So I say, fare thee well, my brother, and may God richly keep you in his safekeeping. Could you rest in peace?
I want to tell the family, especially my mom, that she should take heart. It's very difficult at this time, but she should continue to be the strength that she has exuded. And it's just amazing that she's been able to withstand all this far. I want to tell my sister, Abuma Sikenama, to hold her head high and stay focused on her studies and her children. I want to tell my brother, Didi Ejayanohama, to also stay quite as focused, probably even more focused at this time, since he's the only man left in the family, so that we can all follow him and he can lead by example.
He loved his grandchildren, and that was one thing that always made him proud, especially when they used to call him Grandpa Gogo. But yes, we still miss him. I mean, we will definitely miss him each and every day. Every day, it's like one of the days that we all think that he's gone out on one of his trips and he'll be coming home soon. And we keep in hope and waiting to see him, even though eventually we do come to the recognition that it's going to be hard for him to come back. But we still keep praying that he would be in a better place.
I want to tell my daddy's grandson, my son James, that grandpa loved him very, very much, and he did as well. So he should always continue to keep grandpa's memories in his mind and his heart and not forget. To the rest of his grandchildren, Kimani, Chloe, Koshi, and Jaden, we will continue to pour memories of grandpa on them so they do not forget and learn, just as my grandmother used to tell me stories of my great grandparents that I wasn't necessarily familiar with.
Muhu Kojo, mi dia ma Kojo. Kojo mom kare de baby ya roba hen ram ka ma me ni ana me yebo amola. Ka kre bibi aniku. Sendo ala no we hihle ye. Tiabo Nyamre vawokra ezi. Maya kraye kayareke. Nyamre evawokra ezi. Kuju tiabwe. Muhunju tiabwe.